Hello students, I hope you all are safe at home. Welcome in SST class day 2. Yesterday I had discussed introduction of lesson, our rights and duties, objectives and important terms with you. Hope you have read page 127 till Republic and revised the terms. Now before we start further, let me take feedback of previous topic. When did India become independent? When did our constitution come into force? When do we celebrate Republic Day? Who is known as the father of constitution? What do you mean by constitution? Give definition of the following terms. Number 1, preamble. Number 2, democratic. Number 3, socialist. Number 4, secular. Number 5, republic. I hope you all are able to answer all these questions. Now, let me start today's topic, fundamental rights. Once discuss the objectives. Number 1, what are fundamental rights? Why is there a need of fundamental rights? What is the importance of fundamental rights? Give some fundamental rights. Before we start the topic, let us discuss terms of today's topic. Number 1, fundamental rights. Basic rights given to a citizen of the country to lead a happy life. Number 2, citizens. People who were born and live in a country. Now, let's start reading. Fundamental rights. The Constitution of India gives certain basic rights to its citizens. Constitution, I have already discussed with you, means a set of rules according to which a country is ruled. Citizens means people who were born and live in a country. These rights cannot be denied to any citizen. Denied means refused. If anyone feels that any of his or her fundamental rights is denied, he or she can go to the court for justice. Justice means nyaya, fairness. In simple words, we can say that our constitution gives every citizen some basic rights. These are called fundamental rights. These rights are for the well-being of the citizens. We can move to the court to protect these rights if they are denied. Now, there are some fundamental rights given to the citizens of India. Number 1, right to equality. Number 2, right to freedom of speech and expression. Number 3, right to follow any religion. Number 4, right to justice. Number 5, right to live and travel anywhere in the country. Number 6, right to choose any profession. Number 7, right to free and compulsory education for all children up to the age of 14. Now, I will discuss all these rights one by one. Number 1, right to equality. Right to equality means that all citizens are equal before the law. All citizens, irrespective of their religion, caste, race and place of birth, are treated as equals. Number 2, right to freedom of speech and expression. Expression means the action of making known one's feelings. Freedom of speech and expression means the right to express one's own opinions freely by words of mouth, writing, printing, picture, or any other mode. Next, number 3, right to follow any religion. Right to follow any religion means that all people are free to follow any religion and free to worship any god. So here the question arises, in what way is the right to religion given to the citizens of India different from that of the people in Pakistan, Bangladesh and Sri Lanka, our neighboring countries? The right to religion is given to the citizens of India different from that of the people in Pakistan, Bangladesh and Sri Lanka because in these countries they have adopted an official religion. But in India, people are free to follow any religion and India is a secular country. Next, number 4, right to justice. Justice means Nyay, fairness. Right to justice means people have a right to be protected from crime as well as right to justice when they are its victims. Or means to say that all citizens should have the right to participate in the social, economic and political justice without any discrimination of caste, color, creed, religion or birth of place. Next, number 5. Right to live and travel anywhere in the country. Right to live and travel anywhere in the country means that every citizen has a freedom to live and travel in any part of the country. So students, anybody can travel anywhere in the country. Next, number 6. Right to choose any profession. Profession means occupation. Right to choose any profession means that everyone has the right to be involved in every work and free to choose any occupation. So students, it is up to you that which profession you want to opt in future. Now last is right to free and compulsory education for all children up to the age of 14. Means that every child up to the age of 14 has right to free and compulsory education and also does not allow children below 14 years of age to be employed. According to this right, nobody can force the children below the age of 14 to work in factories, etc. Every child has a right to get free and compulsory education up to the age of 14. I hope children, this topic is clear to all. No doubt, our constitution has given all these rights to us, but rights and duties go hand in hand. Tomorrow I will discuss fundamental duties with you. So students, your homework is reread topic fundamental rights, revise terms and write on copy, and do HOTS on page 130. Thank you.